One of the things I want to show you is if you see these cables come down, they break off. They're pyrotechnically severed right before impact. So the four cables that lead into the ground aren't held on to the test article. They break. So this gives you an idea of what they're pyrotechnically severed at the pullback, and then they're released, and then gravity takes its course. At the end, there's a planer that pulls it off. Here's a case where we built a smaller version called a boiler plate. And again, we just built a big mound of soil. We just wanted to look at the behavior of it and a boiler plate so that we could test over and over and over again, keep the instrumentation, it won't fail. Okay, so after we decided we're going to do landing, let's look at the airbag system that exists right now. And this is probably not an airbag system, but you're familiar with it. It's an airbag inside an airbag. So the outside bursts, the energy that's taken out is pushing that air through that little orifice right there, and then the inside maintains the buoyancy to keep it afloat. And so you start with, again, you see you're starting to build up to look like a real crew module. You drop these things, they're great. Now let's put it into a swing. See what happens here. And it doesn't behave as what you would imagine with a drop. Then if you introduce shear loads into something, it behaves much differently. Here's another company, another vendor that came out. We start with the drop. The drop looks really good. We've optimized the design. This is like a Kleenex box blowing up. As you get to the swing part of it, you can see what happens to the front. The front completely decimates up. The shear loads just rip out the inside and the outside air. So this is one of those head scratchers that you don't really know until you test. This is kind of obscured by the soil, but you'll see this video on the other side. You can see the outside burst right here, which is what it's supposed to do, and you'll see the inside fail as well. Again, you start to get to a much bigger system, get to something that's a little more accurate to the mass of the crew module, put that into a swing. You know, with the drops, you learn a lot. You can turn it a little bit, give it a little bit of pitch, or roll. Then you get to the point of putting it into a swing again. Here's another one. We got to ones where eventually they got real nice and steady when they came down the load real nice. Now we get to the swing, and we almost tip the thing over. So this whole series of tests was done over the span of 2 years. And it wasn't that the airbags didn't perform well. I mean, there is this problem, which can potentially be designed out. You can activate when it wants to burst, when it doesn't. You can potentially develop it. But the problem really was this whole system was weight. You know, how much weight you had to carry with all these airbags and what you were allowed to carry. How were you going to deploy that under the heat shield? Eventually, the decision was made, we're going to go back to the water. So, and there, some of that was programmatic, and some of that was based on this testing. So let me see what else is. I know why that's in super slow model. Okay, here's a case where when they decided to go back to water, we didn't have a pool. So how do you manage water? There are people around that I work with that do simulations where we splash in the crew module in the water and we try to figure out what the loads are. We have a pretty good idea what the acceleration pulse looks like. It's a lot longer than in the ground, and it's not as high. So what can we do in the meantime while we were proposing this pool, the impact basin, to do some testing, understand what the loads were going to be on the astronauts when they're sitting kind of suspended in a pallet, and there's a bunch of struts on that pallet. And those struts are really one-time use things. When they land, they're going to stroke, and they're going to take that energy, and they're not to be used. They're locked on ascent, and they activate during impact or during landing. So here's a case where we took paper honeycomb. We just dropped this major frame, and we're able to tune the acceleration pulse. And we can make our little pyramid design. And those things, as they crush, they just kind of limit the amount of load that goes up into that framework. That framework, that yellow frame, is going to hold in the next image, you'll see a green ring, and then that green ring is supposed to be where the astronauts are suspended. And then that green ring has got a bunch of struts surrounding it, and you'll see it kind of strokes and just kind of stops like that. So that's kind of testing we did after we knew we had to go back to the app. We learned a lot about how do we characterize those struts, how well do they perform. So that's the type of stuff we did. Another one of the things that we had to look at was, okay, there is a contingency. If you have to abort, you have to come back to the Space Center. So how does this bare heat shield behave just in beach sand? And so we made a little tiny litter box, and then we made a much bigger litter box that's 100 feet long and 4 feet tall. So in this case, we have a 70-foot drop tower over here on one of the legs of the gantry. And then we start with the drops, and then we go right next to the swing. So they're not very dramatic impacts, but...
Three, two,
but again, four cables that are pyrotechnically severed right at release. That's pyrotechnically severed and you hit the ground. And it's not very dramatic, but it's just the behavior of how beach sand works. So, you know, it turns out this design is okay for beach sand and it's not for other soils and other compact soils. So, here's an example of work that we're doing with helicopters. We're still doing crash testing of helicopters. If you look around, I've got a few more toys I get to play with out here. I've got an H-46 sitting over there that I'd love to do a test with. I work primarily with helicopters, which is why I'm not working on that. This is a test you may or may not have seen on the NASA Langley YouTube sites or anything else. This is a test where we took a lightweight helicopter. And imagine a big piece of honeycomb. Imagine you take Kevlar and you embed it with some epoxy, and then you put a bunch of glue lines on it, and if you do that and you stack it the right way and you pull it out, you create honeycomb. If you create deep enough, what happens is it behaves like a passive energy absorber. It's a little different than an airbag. It's more like your crumple zone in your car. Where's your crumple zone in your car? It's a tube with a little bit of a kink in it, so if you ever have a frontal impact, it starts folding on itself. And all that folding motion absorbs energy. Well, imagine 100 of those stacked on top of each other like a honeycomb. Every one of those folds, and that takes out a lot of energy. So we had actually proposed that for Orion years ago. They didn't like the technological readiness level. It's called TRL. They said, you know, it's not ready for prime time. So that's fine. We'll try this on a helicopter. Let's get a real airframe. Let's put it in a real condition, a severe but survivable condition. Let's see what kind of loads we can get out of it. And what you'll see here are two segments that are about 2 feet by 2 feet by 1 feet, foot and a half tall. There's two right here. They're just mounted underneath, so they're already deployed out. And it sounds pretty violent, but if you actually look at the data, it wasn't that bad. This is an MD-500 helicopter, which is your standard traffic helicopter. It's not very heavy. It's, the military version is called the OH-6. It's about 3,000 pounds, four occupants. What you should see here in this test is that those cells, one of the cell walls, should buckle. And what you got here was a combination of buckling and folding. And so at first glance, we were trying to get zero pitch rolling yaw, and we got a little bit of pitch. We got a lot of yaw, as you can see. Just based upon the way the cable loads were, sort of the preloads right before release. Again, once you release it, it's just gravity. There's not much you can do about it. You can't control the impact. So one of the things we did after this is we took apart the helicopter. It was pretty much intact, except for one little part of the belly underneath here. We rebuilt that. We took the helicopter, we took the landing gear out, put new landing gear in, did a test without that. So the numbers that we got out of here were about 10 to 15 Gs. 10 to 15 Gs is survivable. It's what normally is exposed for ejection seat testing. If you know, if you actually are a pilot and you want to go up, we took this portable energy absorber out, did the same test. I would call it a fully destructive test. We went up to 50 degrees, which is injurious, potentially fatal. So, just showed this is kind of the research that we do here, where we want to just look at certain concepts and whether they're viable in terms of performance. Once we got the hydro impact basin, we were trying to figure out, well, how are we going to splash in the test article? And the idea is that we couldn't just bring it into the ground anymore. We had to take it in a platform and drop it. So we built a little pool, and we took a pass and just dropped it into the pool to see if we could hit that thing in the target that we wanted. So the idea is that you use all the speed from the swing, and then you release it with a bunch of pyrotechnic bolts this time. So from the time of release to the time of impact is 55 feet. Distance-wise, so that gave us a little bit of confidence that we could do what we're doing now. So again, this is our mini pool. If you look at the high-speed video, you actually see this thing didn't come out zero pitch, but that's one of the things you learn as you release this thing. You have four bolts that are sheared off, and then that thing just drops. So anyways, once we got to that point, we had enough confidence, we were approved to have the hydro impact basin built, and now it's just digging a hole and filling it with water. But anyways, this was a very big deal in terms of what we wanted to do for Orion. We wanted to have these unique capabilities here. We wanted to make sure this was an asset to anybody who wanted to do this kind of testing, not just dropping, but we can swing this thing in. So, and this was built last winter. So
one of the tests you'll see, I think one of the last tests you'll see, is the test that was done at the end of the summer. Yeah, test three. This is one, and I guess I'll explain some of this stuff too. So this is called the integration platform. You'll see that out there. There's a set of sort of screws that adjust the pitch so that you can have a certain pitch on release. There's a set of bolts here that release that cut. And then things just splashes in. We happen to have some arresting, we have some chain out here, some anchor chain tied to these floats, tied to this net, so if we don't hit the back of the pool, or hit the back of the basin and flip it over, and you'll see what happened here in this test. You can see it has a pretty high pitch attitude. So about what you can see today. Hopefully we don't see that. So that's why we test. That's a pretty high pitch angle. That's almost like one of the worst conditions. What we have to test to is out of the three parachutes that come down, one of them that doesn't deploy. So now we're coming down fast, and we're coming down with small winds. Here's a camera view from the top of the gantry. And I think we have a view from the integration platform, too. I might be focused there. I'm not sure. And yeah, so these little floats were just to keep this thing from hitting the back edge of the basin. Here's on the integration platform. Here's one of the hero cams we have on there. So we've got this thing fully instrumented with over 200 channels of accelerometers, strain gauges. We've got, high-speed cameras on it. You'll see high-speed cameras all over the place. We do photogrammetry where we track targets and make sure we understand the velocities on impact. So, anyways, this is the one on the integration platform. We actually have one on the...
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, release! Five, four, three, two, one.